Hey everybody, welcome back to another reaction. This time we're hopping into the Community Season 1, Episode 8, titled Home Economics. Last episode I thought was absolutely comedy gold, 10 out of 10. It's probably the best, it is the best episode of Community that I've seen to this date. If you guys are telling me that episodes are going to be just as good, if not better in the future, I'm super excited to see that. I love like awkward comedy, and last episode was just nothing but awkward ass comedy. I loved how it ended too. Like, it felt very Dark Knight. The music was swelling up and it felt very like heroic and majestic. And I don't know, just saying Abed as the Caped Crusader was just, you know, icing on the cake for an already perfect episode. So, which brings us to this episode, Home Economics. I've heard about the class, never took it. I can only assume home economics is basically, I know it's made fun of, like the generalization is, it's just like a BS class, like how you just basically how you be like an adult or something, but I don't know exactly what it's about. I assume it's teaching you how to be an adult, I guess, like a homemaker or something. I'm not sure, like how to balance a checkbook, or I don't know, cook, how to survive. How to, you know, be an adult. I don't know. But I'm eager to hop into it because this show is always like, you know, hitting me with surprises around each corner. And I want to see more of these characters. I'm really enjoying them, especially Jeff and Britta are my top. But, you know, quickly rising up the ranks, Annie for sure. Abed is always like low-key one of my favorites. Pierce always does that random ass shit. Shirley's good too. Troy is, you know, he's alright. You know, the football jock. Can't relate, so. Anyways, we're just gonna hop into this and have a good old time. If you enjoyed this video by the end of it all, like, comment, share, and subscribe is the key here. For future episodes, I do have Patreon available. Multiple tiers to choose from. So if that interests you at all, links are in the description or pinned in the top comment. Check that out. Otherwise, we're just going to enjoy our time here on YouTube. So, all right, guys, I think that's about it. I'm going to stop yapping, and we're just going to hop in here and have a good old time. All right, guys, here we go.
Buenos dias, winger.
Jeff, how old are you? Who falls asleep in class like that? Like, even if it's
community.
I'm sure Annie likes that.
Say there are two friends and they're in the same class and one of them wants to ask the other one out on a date.
Oh, he's talking about a different girl and Annie's gonna think it's her. Unless he's just trying to smash, so.
Oh, you thought. I can't believe I misled you like that. Listen. Randy can be the name of a guy or a girl. And in this case, it is definitely a girl.
Well, I'm sure it's not Randy Orton. Unless his ass gets RKO'd by the end of the episode.
Oh my god, an RKO!
You're welcome. And I hate you.
I like that. That little detail that Jeff and Britta just walked by. Like, they're not important. They're just other students. I like that detail. That was really neat.
In fashion, I'm what's known as a tastemaker.
And you missed an entire side of your face shaving.
Here comes Vaughn. Bye.
Oh, crap.
Oh, this guy's still around.
Vaughn. Oh, the guy with the tiny nipples you did it with.
Why are you making this awkward? It's been like how many episodes?
You know what? You're like the exact opposite of an antioxidant. Yeah. I get band practice late.
Yeah,
can't
Britta.
We still be
don't
friends?
Be an oxidant.
Isn't the word later already short enough?
Cloudy,
don't talk to Vaughn.
And Pierce is going to talk to Vaughn.
That is girl for talk to Vaughn.
This episode feels different. We haven't had the opening theme song or anything. Kind of just going into the Is Jeff homeless?
That boy's living in his car.
Oh, Brittles, I forgot to tell you, I went and talked to Vaughn.
What?
Bad news is I could not patch up things between you. You really didn't. Good news is I'm the new keyboardist in his band.
Oh, hi, Jeff. We were just talking about how in today's economy...
Living in your car, living in your car, you are living in your car? I'm sorry, I'm not good at being coy.
Oh, it's a very temporary issue. I've just got to pay some meaningless fees, and then they'll put my locks back on the door, and that'll be that.
You can stay with me in the dorms. My room has a bunk bed, which is kind of a misnomer because it's the real deal.
This is my first college girl, so I really want to impress her. Would you mind helping me shop for this stuff?
No!
I'd love to.
Really?
Fucking sure. Annie, man.
Thanks.
Why don't you have dinner at my place? I got a hot plate that plugs into a cigarette lighter.
Yeah, but your kitchen's being towed.
No!
Stop! That's my house!
How are you so satisfied all the time, Abed? I mean, don't you ever want anything more out of life than cereal?
Yeah.
Sometimes I like to pour hot cocoa mix into cold milk and drink it like a cold hot chocolate.
Picnic blanket. Genius.
Annie. I hope the twist is Troy is really gonna take Annie.
Thanks.
Tell that boy how you feel.
It's scary. If he's not interested, I could lose the friendship too.
Love is a gamble always, but waiting won't change the dice. You either roll them or you lose your turn.
I'm going to roll them. I am. I need a few more shakes.
Shake them in your mind. Okay?
Is it keyboard? All right.
Now, if you'll excuse me, Pierce's band is playing and I want to record the train wreck. This isn't weird for you?
No.
Britta, you're so fake right now.
Support to help smooth things over.
Saying goodbye to Britta was the hardest thing to do.
He's about to throw all the shade right now.
I'm getting rid of Britta.
What am I doing?
I'm getting rid of the bee.
She's an all good bee.
I'm getting rid of Britta. I'm getting rid of the bee. She's a GDB.
Disrespectful to me and to the definition of rhyme scheme.
I'm an artist, and I write what I feel, and I feel that you suck.
Can I have a word with you?
Can you come here, please?
Listen, I know Britta's your friend, but my song is more
important. Get it? You're jealous of me.
What?
Why? I don't know, maybe because when I put on these skinny jeans, my ass looks like a baby pumpkin.
My band, my song. Oh,
yeah. Pierce, did you just defend my honor?
Oh, yeah, totally.
Oh, this is sad.
And she'll take a bite, and she'll take a bite, and you'll laugh.
I couldn't have done this without your help. You're really nice.
Remember when you pretended to be my backpack?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I want to give Annie a hug.
Troy,
this
wait.
Is sad.
I have to tell you. My appendix is bursting.
God damn it.
Okay.
Oh, no. Students. This guy.
Thanks for bringing me here.
Doesn't seem to be anything wrong with you.
Cool.
Yeah, see ya.
Oh!
Where does it hurt?
This is a date?
Yeah, you need these.
I'll be thinking of you.
Okay, I need to go.
Oh, Annie, please.
You need to take Jeff back.
Never had him. Don't want him. Especially now he's got a real Phil Spector vibe going.
Use your lady parts.
Abed!
Don't be naive, Britta. The charge between you two is keeping him going. Tell him you'll make love to him if he takes a shower and finds a nice place to live.
Don't tease him like that, though, Britta.
No.
You promised sex. He's gonna find a place to live right now.
You're into me.
I beg your unbelievable pardon.
Look at all this work you're doing just to have me around again.
I was doing this all for
reading between the lines. Smart guy.
Yeah, clearly. Do me a favor, will you lay off Britta? I mean, she may walk like she just got off a horse, but underneath all that clown makeup, she's a good kid.
I've moved on.
Yeah, I see. Who is it gonna be?
Yes, I don't need you in my band. I am my own person. And Pierce, you're a bee.
Yeah.
Pierce, you're a bee.
No!
Before you two proceed, I have one thing to say. I want my name's blanket back. Do you guys mind? Could you scoot over? Have a nice date. I don't care what you think. For me, that was huge. I know, sweetie. Let's go find you some pants.
Damn, we almost got some Annie ass cheek right there.
Thanks. Carrie.
Hey.
You look like you moved out.
You would have been fine with me staying there forever, huh?
Yep.
Nah.
You're pretty cool, Abed.
You're a huge nerd.
Thanks.
Coming from Abed, that's amazing.
My peers. Yeah, talk about me.
Good night, Green Day. And everybody hates him, even all his friends. When you come after Pierce, then the battle is on. So this rap goes out to a stupid Vaughn.
Well played, Pierce. This isn't over.
Oh, is this gonna be a rivalry? I could get into this. Okay, that was Community Season 1, Episode 8, titled Home Economics. Okay, guys. Question. Most of these titles, like Home Economics, they feel like they're titles of something that I'm expecting, but the episode just seems to be totally different. Like, last episode was called Introduction to Statistics, and I don't know, I was expecting a math-centered episode, and yet we got the most epic Halloween episode I've ever seen on TV. I mean, that and the Halloween on The Office episodes was really good, but yeah, that was probably one of my favorite episodes in all of comedy. And I'm just like, where did the Introduction to Statistics get into play? So here, I'm just like, okay, Home Economics. It was more of like, you know, relating to Jeff's living situation, obviously. But I just thought we were going to get more classroom-based stuff. So, you know, that's just on me. I don't know why I'm expecting this type of stuff. I don't know if I'm just, you know, that's just me. Is anyone else like that? Did anyone else think, you know, we're getting, like, these names of classes? Like, is that what it is? Like, I don't know. I haven't even noticed that. Are these just... No, okay. They're not just names of classes. Because football, feminism, and youth, that's not a class. I guess we'll figure it out. But if you guys let me know about the titles and the meanings and all that good stuff. Like, I'm enjoying the show so far. But Home Economics, I just expected something different. Still love the episode. I'm loving the little rivalry that we're getting between Pierce and Vaughn. Totally excited to see Vaughn back. Hopefully that means we're going to get Badger back again soon. I keep calling him Badger just because that's how I know him as from Breaking Bad. What else happened? Jeff and Britta, they're getting closer. Okay, so the big takeaway from this episode, the Annie Troy stuff is so awkward. Now, I usually don't like watching that kind of awkward romance stuff on TV shows because I've already lived through some awkward romance stuff. So seeing it again, like third hand, it's giving me like third hand cringe, embarrassment, and you know, I guess you could say it hits a little too close to home. But I've been in situations where I was Annie, and I've been in situations where I was Troy. It sucks. Especially looking back on it, but obviously you don't think about that kind of stuff in the moment. Because in the moment, you obviously want what you want. And obviously Troy wanted Randy, is that her name? And of course Annie has a crush on Troy, trying to make sure they have a good date. It was just very awkward. And I'm just like, I hope we get Troy and Annie together at some point. Or Annie and somebody. Even if Troy's just going to be like, the football jock, maybe they just won't be together. Like, I know that they kind of hint that they're an item ever since episode one. Like, they've been at odds, like they went to the same high school. She's the pill popper, he's the jock. You know, so they have chemistry, they have history. So I feel like the show wants us to root on that relationship. But I don't know if that would work. I mean, that's just me thinking. Maybe Troy, I feel like they're setting it up where Jeff is going to be with Britta. Troy is going to be with Annie. What about Abed? Maybe Abed and Annie. Let's start some different shipping here. You know, what if Jeff doesn't wind up with Britta? What if Britta winds up with Pierce? I don't know. I'm just spitting some shit out, but thought the episode was good. It was definitely a hard follow up with the very last episode, which was completely like unbelievably epic. But this episode was good as well. Really enjoying how we're getting, you know, more fleshed out characters. I like how Shirley's taking on that motherly role to kind of get Annie to kind of stop being so pathetic. I don't know what other word to use, but that was awkward as fuck. Saying Annie like take her nanny's blanket away from Troy and his date. And she's just, she looks crazy as fuck in the hospital gown. And she's like, mine. Have a great date. Oh, that was awkward. Oh, that's so good. So good. So yeah, I don't know what to expect with the next episode. Really enjoying the show so far. I don't think there's an episode I haven't liked yet. And yeah, I'm just looking to keep on laughing and keep on rolling. So if you enjoyed this episode, I do have future episodes available right now on my Patreon. So if that interests you, links are in the description down below. Let me know what you liked about my video or what you didn't like. I always want to improve and get better content out for you guys. But that being said, I think I'm just going to leave it there. Like, comment, share, and subscribe. I'm going to get out of here. I'll talk to you guys later. All right, guys. Adios.